Alaska, you know, in my mind, is the untamed country. I missed my flight the first time out, but I was lucky enough to get a replacement flight, connected with these guys in Seattle, and we flew into Juneau and then over to Gustavus. My name is Bill Gazier. I'm the community marketing specialist at Field & Stream.
Thank you. I enjoy doing any type of fishing trips, hunting trips with people that I'm friends with, but something I like even more is meeting new people along the way and getting to be friends. And I'm up here with the Field & Stream crew, and we're gonna be fly fishing in Alaska.
I've been fly fishing since I was about 10. The story goes that my dad and I were out fishing one day, and I saw guys upstream from us, and they were doing the back cast. It was sort of a river runs through it moment for me, and I said, Dad, I want to try that out. And so we went all into it. I never really turned back. I fell in love with it and fell in love with the tradition behind it. I never wanted to do anything but fly fish, and I've been blessed to be able to fly fish all over the place, and now I finally made it to Alaska.
Since I was a little girl, I always wanted to fly fish. I love going fishing, but I never really had the opportunity to learn until earlier this year, I got to go to Belize, and it was amazing.
I got one great cast right in the middle of them, and I hooked up on a big bonefish. My first big one on a fly rod. Awesome. What a beautiful fish.
But it was gonna be a lot different than this fly fishing trip up in Alaska. We're gonna be going after different species, you know, totally different types of flies. Down in Belize, we were dealing with wind, lots of sunshine, so two very different things, but it should be a great time.
Whee!
Here you go, sir.
Thanks, bro.
Well, we're out here in Alaska, we're getting ready now. I was a little delayed, so these guys got to fish without me yesterday, but today we're going out for halibut. Have you been halibut fishing before?
No, this is the first time.
The very first day out here, we got to go out and do some saltwater fishing. Now, we were gonna be going after halibut, and I was really excited.
My first time out saltwater fishing like that from a boat. I'm a fly fisherman from back east, so that was a great experience.
Hey, man, I don't know. Okay, never mind.
I know, it's not coming in, right?
Yeah.
That's because he's big.
Look at the fish.
That's a good sign.
That's a good sign there.
We caught the pink salmon on the first day, and we used that as bait for the second day. We're using big tackle, big circle hooks. We got into some big halibuts.
Oh, that thing is a big one.
But that one was too big. This one's perfect size for eating. That's what we're here for, and worked out great. I really want to catch a big one, but after how much I struggled with this one, better up my game.
Get it!
We had a great guide. He was quite a character. A lot of laughs, a lot of smiles, a lot of high fives. Reeling those suckers in is not an easy task.
Please edit that.
Another one over there?
Hooked up right here.
Woo, we got a double.
Yeah.
Turtle man.
Wow, look at how big it is.
I got the tension still. I think it's as big as Bachman's, isn't it?
You see it? Is it good? Oh, yeah.
Oh, look at him run.
Melissa showed me how to do it.
Got him.
Nice.
Nice.
Well, it wasn't legal size, and lives to fight another day.
Well, we've been having just an awesome time. We've had doubles on. Fish are going crazy right now. Whew, and they keep getting bigger. So that's a good thing.
Sportsman's Alliance, our heritage, our fight. Protecting hunting from coast to coast.
Did you know the Sportsman's Alliance submitted comments in opposition to U.S. Fish and Wildlife's proposed takeover of public lands in Alaska? Just another fun fact showing you how sportsmen and women are helping make a difference.
Wearing me down.
Keep going, keep going. Put it in free spool.
Got him.
Nice.
We just finished an awesome day of out fishing for halibut. I was worried that it was gonna be rainy, not nice, but it turned out to be a beautiful day. We had totally calm water and had a whole bunch of fun. Now tomorrow, we're heading over to the streams. We're gonna go in, it should be really nice. I'm hoping it's not gonna be raining all day because it makes it a lot more fun when it's nice weather, but we had a wonderful day and can't wait to get to the rivers tomorrow. We just got on the boat. Now we're actually going to go out and we're going to fish some of the streams today, but they're literally going to just drop us off. The captain's going to stay in the boat making sure it stays with the tide, and we're going to go out and hit the rivers.
The Idaho Bay is not close to where we are. We had to travel about 2 hours on the boat to get there and back. We experienced some really choppy waters through that icy strait, but you just gotta muscle through it.
Some of the things that I love about doing these trips is not only going out there with people that you get to be great friends with, but testing out all the new gear. Now, one of the things they had were a new set of waders, and they have nailed it with these. They are a perfect fit. The neoprene booties go right in the boots, and they are comfortable to walk in. Plus, it gave me really good traction. A lot of times you're not just standing in a stream fishing, you've got to get to and from the locations, and I was really impressed. Woohoo! First fish. I don't know what it is, but it bit and I caught it, and I'm pretty happy about that. Woohoo! Yeah! Told you we were both winners.
Nice. Gray ghost. Classic fish. Pattern. She caught a char, and that was an awesome experience to see her face light up and catch that fish. That was awesome.
Yep. Ooh, look at that. That is awesome. My first fish up here in Alaska on a fly rod. We've only been out here maybe 5 minutes. What a beautiful fish.
The water comes up through the streams and from the tides. So the stream water is affected by the tide conditions, which I'm really, not used to fishing. The water can raise up like a foot in 10 minute time. So it's a challenge fishing that. Well, tough conditions. Tides coming in, made the water high. Picking a lot of debris off the line.
The tide's coming in fast as can be here. Get back to the boat and maybe try something else, but
yeah.
Got one fish.
Yeah.
It's a start. Go team.
Go team.
When you're looking to book a fishing trip, one of the things that's nice is you can go to a place like Glacier Bay Country Inn and you can have beautiful accommodations, yet be out in the wilderness in only an hour and be fishing where it literally looks like there's been nobody ever there before.
it's pretty much lived up to all my expectations. We've seen some people, but you know, in the grand scheme of things, we've been in some really remote places, and it's just beautiful country, great fishing. Couldn't ask for a better trip.
That was an awesome end to an evening.
Yeah, that was really cool.
Ideally, don't really like being out here unarmed, but it was pretty neat to see him. That's the third bear we've seen this evening fishing.
Yeah, that was about as close as we'd want to get to him, huh?
They stay on this side, we stay on this side, we all go home, everybody's happy.
Yep. Fishing with friends and sharing my tradition and my passion is really what it's all about.
This segment was brought to you by Boss Buck. For the most user-friendly and dependable feeder on the market, choose Boss Buck feeders. Now you're getting serious. Winchester Deadly Passion is presented by Cuttyback Digital. More deer, fewer blanks. Hard-hitting Easton Arrows. Golden Triangle Whitetail. Winchester, the American legend. National Deer Alliance, HHA Sports, Scent Killer Gold with Hunt Dry Technology, apply it, dry it, and go hunt, Rage Broadheads, leading the evolution in lethal technology, Convergent Hunting Solutions, where experience, innovation, and passion meet, Sportsman's Alliance, protecting hunting from coast to coast, Engel Coolers, the original high-performance cooler company. And Moose Utility Division, your leader in ATV, UTV accessories.
Wrapping up this trip to Alaska, I couldn't have asked for a better trip. We had so much fun together, laughing, joking around on the boat, walking back to some of the most beautiful streams you could ever imagine, catching huge halibut. It was just a trip that I will never forget. And on the last evening, to top it all up, we got to see a beautiful brown bear. And I couldn't help but think about one of my other favorite trips when I finally got to go brown bear hunting in Alaska on the peninsula. Now we're up here brown bear hunting, but what we've decided to do, we've got an entire huge valley in front of us to glass over. So we've got our camp down below, and we're just hiking up to the highest point that we can get so we can do a bit of glassing. I have miles and miles of country to cover. So as soon as we spot them, we gotta group together, make a plan, and get down after these bears.
We're really lucky on the peninsula and in Alaska as a whole. There's so few people that get to take advantage of this resource. It's one of the lowest densities of humans on the planet to begin with, but when you look around and you don't see anyone for miles and miles and miles, you just gotta feel lucky. We're the only ones in these areas that are actually hunting brown bear, and it's terrific.
After days and days of hunting, our spirits were still high as we knew we were in an incredible area. But finally, all the glassing paid off as we had spotted a bear about 3.5 miles out on the tundra. Now on this hunt, both my cameraman and I had a tag, and we had agreed to switch off on stalks. He was up, so I grabbed the camera and we were off to the races. Mike's second shot, well, it dropped the bear right in his tracks, but unfortunately, I was just a little too short and couldn't quite see it.
Probably biggest bear of the year right there.
That thing is monster.
Yeah.
Check that out.
The good news was we still had a few days left, so now I was back hunting and excited to have one of our two bears down. Well, Ryan and I were glassing and we spotted a beautiful, extremely blonde bear. And the best part is, it was in an area that we thought we could make a stock. This is awesome. We've been hunting hard out here. We're up here in Alaska, and this has been a hunt that I wanted to do for a long time, and we got it done. We made a lot of great stocks, saw some beautiful bear. We're here with Ryan McCune. It's been just an awesome trip, and we've got one beautiful bear down. I don't think I've ever seen one this blonde before.
This segment was brought to you by Convergent Hunting Solutions. Try their electronic game calls today, featuring Bluetooth technology to work right with your smartphone. Winchester Deadly Passion is presented by Winchester, the American legend. Matthews Archery, catch us if you can. Field and Stream, where traditions begin. ScoutLookWeather.com. Download the free ScoutLook hunting app for your smartphone. Rangemaster Trailers. Luxury gone rugged. Master Hand Milling. Revolutionizing the range. Reinhardt. The best archery targets in the world. Garmin. Enhance your outdoor adventures. Winchester. The American legend. S4 Gear. Sure Shot Jewelry. Check out the Melissa Bachman collection today. And Boss Buck, for the most user-friendly and dependable feeder on the market. Now you're getting serious. Closed captioning is brought to you by Cuddyback Digital. Upgrade to Cuddyback and your images will never look better.
Alaska, well, they are known for some of the best black bear hunting in the entire country. And what I love about it, well, this was going to be a self-guided hunt. Now, I was flying in with RDM pilot. Ryan McHugh was going to fly me in, had a tent camp location, and from there, well, I was on my own. I had a kayak, a tent, my bow, and a predator call. My goal on this trip was to really kayak around, look for those black bears on the beach, and then make a stock. A beautiful bear. This thing is a giant, and he came in on a dime. So in the end, it's easy to see why Alaska is my favorite location in the whole world. They have amazing fishing, beautiful scenery, and absolutely incredible hunting. This is my third year up here, my third big boar with a predator call. These guys, They're pretty mean and hungry when they come out of the dens in the winter. Alaska's got some absolute giant black bear. This is what spring black bear hunting is all about.
This segment was brought to you by Range Master Trailers, the ideal combination of rugged durability and luxurious comfort. Built on a lightweight all-aluminum frame, the Range Master can be customized for all your hunting adventures. Range Master Trailers, luxury's gone rugged.